गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट साई राम. लेट अस लर्न द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ EBS 1 लेसन नंबर 11, अ लुक इन साइड द बॉडी. नाउ इन टूडेज चैप्टर, इन टूडेज वीडियो, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट हाउ डज द हार्ट फंक्शन. द हार्ट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इंटरनल ऑर्गन ऑफ अवर बॉडी एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सी द फंक्शन ऑफ द हार्ट इन टूडेज वीडियो. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट बाई लर्निंग द न्यू वर्ड्स. द फर्स्ट वर्ड FIST, fist. Fist means your, just this is wrist or fist, that is called your fist. Second one, CONTRACTS, contracts. Contracts means it becomes small, it gets reduced, that is known as contracts. And here we are talking about heart. So the heart contracts means the heart. See, the heart contracts, the heart relaxes. So that is, they are, the contracts means it is becoming smaller. And relaxes, it is coming to its regular size. So that is called your heart is beating at every moment, at every second. So that is contract. That is your, when you are breathing, when you are this, when you place your hand near your left hand side, you can feel your heart beat. So that is the contraction and the relaxation of heart. Third one is HEART, beat, the heartbeat. The sound that the heart makes is known as the heartbeat. Fourth one, PULSE, pulse. Now pulse, you can feel it near your wrist, that is your fist. There is a, you know, a nerve which is very close to your skin. When you place your hand on that pulse, now the doctors know very exactly how, where it is situated, and when they press it and when they see, they can feel the heartbeat also here. So the pulse is known as the, it tells you the heartbeat. Fifth one is THROBBING. Throbbing is the movement which the heart makes. The contraction and the relaxation of the heart is known as throbbing. Okay, contracting, relaxing, that is known as throbbing. Now see, this is the diagram of your, of our heart. The heart looks like this. Okay, it is red in color because it is full of blood. It is red in color. It pumps blood. That is the main function of the heart. It pumps blood to all parts of the body. So the heart is red in color. Okay, see, and it is situated inside the thoracic cavity. This is your chest. See, can you see? This is your chest, and that is the thoracic cavity. So it is situated, and this is your heart. Can you see? This is your heart. The red color is your heart. It is situated inside the thoracic cavity, somewhat to the left hand side. Okay, little, it is in the center, but a little bit to the left hand side. Okay, so this is the diagram of the heart and where it is situated. The heart is situated inside the thoracic cavity. There is blood in our body. We take in air when we breathe in. Our blood carries the air to all parts of the body. So when we breathe in, when we take the oxygen in, the oxygen mixes with the blood and the blood carries air to all parts of our body. So see, our body functions in such miraculous ways, we don't know also. So inside, so many internal organs are performing so many functions. So what is there in our body? We are made up of bones, we are made up of muscles, we are made up of blood. So there is blood all over our body. See, whenever we fall, whenever we, you know, have a cut in our hand or something cuts, we immediately, blood comes out from the body. So there is blood all over the body, all parts of the body, blood is there. And when we breathe in, when we take the oxygen in, the blood carries the air to all parts of the body. So the blood is supplying air to all parts of the body. The food that we eat gets digested. It is again blood that carries the digested part to every particle of the body. The food that we eat gets digested in the stomach, and stomach is situated in the abdominal cavity. So the digestion process takes place in the abdominal cavity, and then it is the blood again which functions. It carries the digested part, whatever we eat, and the things from where, the food from which we get nutrients, minerals, vitamins, whatever it is, it carries the digested part to every particle of the body. So it is transporting the nutrients to all parts of the body. Who is doing that? The blood is doing that. Who is doing that? The blood. The blood is carrying the digested part to every particle of the body so that we get proper nourishment. We get proper nourishment from the food which we have eaten. And the blood plays an important role in carrying the digested part to every particle of the body. For these purposes, it is necessary to keep blood flowing through the blood vessels that spread throughout the body. And for this, what we can do, we can only eat healthy things and exercise regularly. If we do these two things, then the blood will be keep flowing. The blood will keep flowing through the blood vessels properly and they will spread throughout the body very, very easily and very, very properly without any obstructions and without any obstacles. Okay. So for these purposes, to maintain, to function the bodily, the blood flowing inside the body, you only need to eat healthy food and exercise regularly. Then only the functions inside the body will be carried out in a smooth way. And it is very, very necessary that the blood keeps flowing throughout the every part of the body. Somewhat or something happens, if the blood stops flowing to some part of the body, then we fall sick. Okay, then we don't know what has happened internally, we don't know. Then we have to do many tests, we have to undergo some surgeries. So for that reason, you should be very, very careful. You should eat healthy food always and you should exercise regularly so that the blood functions in all your body and keeps flowing throughout the body very, very easily and smoothly. It is the function of the heart to keep the blood flowing. And main thing, I told you, the heart's main function is to keep the blood flowing. When it contracts and when it relaxes, it pumps blood. It pumps blood to all parts of the body. So to keep your heart healthy, you should always eat healthy food. If you eat more of oily foods, if you eat more of unhealthy snacks and food, then the heart, it damages. And then you have breathing problems. And because of that, the blood is not flowing properly to all parts of the body. And then we fall sick. So to keep the heart fit and healthy, always have healthy food, okay, and which is less oily, which is less, you should have less of fried food, which are fried in oil, and it is oily foods you should avoid more, okay, so that you remain healthy, your heart remains healthy, and your heart functions properly, and it gives blood to all parts of the body. So the main function of the heart is to keep the blood flowing, which is very, very important to keep our body functioning in a smooth way. The heart is an important internal organ. All the organs are very, very important. We cannot function without a single organ. But the heart is an important internal organ. And where it is situated? It is situated inside the thoracic cavity at the center and somewhat to the left hand side. It is in the center of the thoracic cavity, a little to the left, just a little bit to the left hand side. But where it is situated, the heart is situated inside the thoracic cavity. And thoracic cavity is your chest. So your heart is situated inside your chest. And your heart's size is like your wrist. See, this is your wrist or fist. So that little bit bigger is your heart. So the heart exactly looks like a wrist, also somewhat like a wrist, and it is little bit bigger than your wrist, okay? It is slightly bigger than one's fist. I told you this fist, this is your fist, okay? And this is your wrist. So your fist, this is your fist part, it is slightly bigger than your fist part. So your height, your heart is here, okay? And where it is the heart, where it is situated? In the thoracic cavity. And where is the thoracic cavity? It is in the chest. The heart contracts. Now what do you mean when the heart contracts? The heart becomes smaller. See, when the heart contracts, it becomes smaller. It is pumping. Okay, it is pumping. The heart contracts, it becomes smaller. and when it relaxes, it comes to the normal size. The heart relaxes. That means the heart returns to its original size. When the heart contracts, it becomes smaller. And when the heart relaxes, it comes to its original size. The heart contracts and relaxes continuously without stopping. Very, very important. The heart should and must contract and relax continuously. Every second, every minute, it is contracting and relaxing. And because of that, you know, our bodily functions are functioning smoothly. So when it relaxes and contracts continuously without stopping, the heart does that contraction and relaxation. When it contracts, the blood in the heart is pushed into the blood vessels. So when it is becoming smaller, when it is contracting, what happens? The blood is pushed into the blood vessels. And from the blood vessels, it is being transferred to all parts of the body. At every contraction, it is pushed further and further. And whenever it contracts, it pushes more further, further, further. So that it gets, the blood flows continuously through all parts of the body, to all organs of the body. So when the heart is contracting, it does this main function of pushing the blood inside the blood vessels. Okay. A contraction of the heart is called as heartbeat. So when your heart contracts, that is known as heartbeat. And you can listen to your heartbeat when you place your, you know, ears near maybe your mother's or father's chest. You can just place your ears for some time on the chest and you can hear the heartbeat. Okay, so you can really hear the heart is ticking like a clock. Tick, tick, tick. You get that sound. That is called as heartbeat. The ticking of the sound, the ticking of the heart. The heart does the sound of ticking at every second. And that sound is known as heartbeat. That means your heart is contracting, your heart is relaxing. If you place your hand on the middle of your chest, a little to the left. See, middle of your chest, but little to your left. You can feel the throbbing of your heart due to the heartbeat. Throbbing means you can feel that your heart is contracting, your heart is relaxing, and then you can hear the sound of the heartbeat. But the environment aside, you should be quiet. There should be nothing, even fans you should off. You should be in a closed room where nothing, you should not listen any sound from outside, and then only you can hear your heartbeats. But if it is noisy, then you cannot hear your heartbeat. So you can try this. In a quiet room, close the windows and fans, everything, and place your hand on your chest. Okay, be quiet, don't move or don't do anything. Sit in one place, relax, keep your hand on your chest, and then you can see that your heart is beating. Okay, you can really feel it. So try this at home. At the wrist, there is a blood vessel that flows. See this, some doctors, when you fall ill, they check your wrist. They place your hand on your wrist. Don't get confused between fist and wrist. This is your fist and this is your wrist. So some doctors place the hands on the wrist and they check the pulse. From here also, you can check your heartbeats, whether they are functioning properly or no. So some doctors check the wrist also. At the wrist, there is a blood vessel that is very close to the skin. If you place your fingers there, you can feel the heartbeats. Okay, so this we maybe some may be knowing to do at home also, there may be some, but the doctors know exactly how to place your hands on the wrist, how to feel the heartbeats. So there is a wrist there, at the wrist there is a blood vessel which is very close to the skin, and when you place your fingers on that, you can actually feel the heartbeats there. Okay, this is called feeling the pulse. And what is this activity called? It is called feeling the pulse. When we are sleeping quietly, the pulse becomes slower. So when we are sleeping, when we are not doing anything, we are not doing any activity, the pulse becomes slow. And when we get up, when we do all sorts of activities, especially running and jumping, the pulse becomes faster. See, you start breathing heavily. That means during that time, your pulse is becoming faster. And when you're sitting quiet or when you're sleeping, when the time of sleeping is the time where the pulse becomes very, very slow. And when you're running and jumping, That means when you're breathing heavily, that means the pulse is becoming faster. The pulse becomes faster. Now we'll take a quick recap of what we have studied in today's video. We have studied everything about heart, which is very, very important. A very important internal organ. What did we study? We studied that the heart keeps the blood flowing through the blood vessels throughout the body. What is the main function of the heart? It pumps blood. It contracts. When it contracts, it pushes blood to the blood vessels. And from the blood vessels give blood to all part of the body. And that is the main function of the heart. So the main function of the heart is it keeps the blood flowing to all parts of the body. Second, the heart is continuously contracting and relaxing. So the contraction and the relaxation of heart is called as throbbing. That means you can feel your heartbeat. It is throbbing. And when you even place your fingers near your wrist, which is very, very close to the blood vessel, you can actually feel your heartbeat. Okay. So the heart should contract and relax. It is contracting and relaxing at every second. And when it is contracting, it is pushing blood to the blood vessels, which gives blood to all parts of the body. And to carry out this function smoothly, the main thing is you should eat healthy food. You should avoid oily foods, especially chips and all what we get in the market is deep fried in the oil, which is not very healthy for the heart. So always eat healthy food and exercise daily so that your heart functions smoothly and you never fall sick. Okay, that is the main reason what I'm telling you for. So understood what is the function of the heart and what is the role of the heart, how does the heart function inside your body, and where is the heart situated? The heart is situated inside the thoracic cavity. The thoracic cavity is in the chest. So, and your heart is situated at the center, a little bit to the left hand side, and it functions, it pushes blood to all parts of the body. Is that clear? Thank you for listening to me carefully. Goodbye, take care. See, this is also point. The contraction of the heart push the blood from the heart into the blood vessel. So what it is does, what as I told you, when you are contracting, the heart is pushing blood from the heart to the blood vessels. Okay, so main function, again I'm telling you, it pushes blood to the blood vessels, which passes through all parts of the body, and the heart is contracting and relaxing at every second. Okay, which is very, very important. And to keep your heart healthy, what you're going to do, you're going to eat healthy food and you're going to exercise regularly. Am I very clear now? Children, I hope you have understood, and thank you for listening to me carefully. Goodbye, take care.